friends, welcome back to the Pragmatic Lopa. A lovely Diwali TORAN or festoon is a must this jubilant season. A TORAN is a symbolic string hung to decorate the main entrance of home, to ward off evil and to please and attract goddess of wealth Maa Laxmi. The preferred TORAN is the traditional one, which is the astonishing combination of mango leaves and marigold flowers, marks any auspicious festive occasion and is a common practice in Indian culture. It absorbs harmful beliefs and allows only the encouraging ones to pass through. TORAN fits perfectly into the archway of doors and is the first thing that welcomes guests. Mango leaves TORAN soil so often and it is imperative to replace with fresh one, which is not always possible in our everyday life. So you can always make them using variety of colors and materials, fabrics or metals resembling mango leaves and other decorative features depending on the region. So this is a last minute creativity, inexpensive, easy and quick to make TORAN to embrace the festivity with a smile. For this URULI and DIYA decor, do check out the link in the description box below. Moreover, main door creates a first impression of a house, so let's begin with creating our impression. As for this TORAN, first I used yellow and orange yarn to make pom-poms to mimic the look of marigold flower. Like I am doing here, you can either wrap it around fingers to a specific number of times depending on the thickness you want your pom-poms to be. Here I wrapped around 3 fingers for 50 times. Once you cut with scissors, carefully remove the lot from all the fingers. Then using a separate piece of yarn, tie it at the center as tight as possible and cut all the loops using pair of scissors. Make sure you cut every single loop. Now keep trimming it till you get the required shape of pom-pom you wish. You are done once you are happy with its size. Let me tell you another way you can make them. Cut a piece of cardboard in this shape of thickness you want your pom-poms to be. Here is the thickness of 3 fingers. Now wrap around it for 50 times like before, and once cut, slide it to the other side. Use a separate piece of yarn, pass it through this gap and tightly tie it at the center. Carefully pull it out and cut out all the loops and trim the edges as before. You can try whichever way suits you the best. At this point, if you find it uneven, you can trim it accordingly. Similarly, I made pom-poms with yellow yarn. You can discard these trimmings, but I collected them to use for some other project which I haven't thought of yet, but I'm sure I'll figure out something. For the bigger pom-poms, I wrapped 80 times around 4 fingers and repeat the same process as I mentioned before. Similarly, 5 red pom-poms I wanted of medium size, so wrapped around 3 fingers for 65 times. So in total, I made 8 small ones in yellow and orange, 6 in red, in medium, 5 of red, big ones in yellow 3, in orange 2. Once done with all the pom-poms, let's make leaves. For the leaves, I took this green fleece fabric, which is damn cheap. I got just half a yard. But you can use whatever you want, either any green fabric to mimic the actual leaves, or green paper, or you can even paint white sheet green. Or if you wish, make it colorful as well. Use your own creativity and choose from available options at home. I'll show you 2 ways of making leaves. First is the common leaf pattern, just to mimic the real mango leaf. Draw a freehand leaf on a piece of paper. Cut it with scissors to use it as a template to trace it on the fabric. Mark the borders using a pen. Cut it out carefully along the borders using a pair of scissors. Once you have your leaf cut, you will need a hot glue gun and anything to decorate the leaf, like I used sequin lace. For this, I use the glossy side of the lace. Apply glue along the border in small parts so before it dries up, neatly set the lace. Continue doing the same until the entire lace border is covered. I didn't include the stem as later it will be folded behind and won't be seen. Now to highlight the veins of the leaf, I use the same lace. Measure the length of the lace that would be required. Once cut, apply glue and set the lace. For other small veins, do the same. Measure, cut, apply glue and fix lace. Trim off if any excess thread is popping up. Similarly, create how many other small veins you want on your leaf. In the same way, create as many leaves as you want for your toran. But mine will be a combination of both. Only two of these typical leaves and others will be with a modern twist. For the modern twist, I made a paper triangle template in dimensions of two equal sides in 22 cm and base of 29 cm. Use this template to trace on the fabric with a pen, then cut it along the border. Similarly, cut out pieces of triangle depending on the number of leaves you want in your festoon. Like I have cut out 4 pieces, and as before, I use the same lace along the border of 2 equal sides, but in a different way. Unlike the previous one, where I used the glossy side of lace, here I'll use a matte side. Like before, use hot glue in small parts to avoid drying up, and soon after apply the lace. Once you are done with one side, chop it off using scissors and work the same way on the other side, leaving only the base to work on. Now fold the base of the triangle, that is the longest side, and in this case it's 29 cm. In the way I'm showing you here, start folding it evenly from sides, slowly progressing towards the center. Now adjust the folds to further even it out before finalizing. Now you can either simply staple all the folds together, which is much easier, but as I do not have a stapler, I'll use just a needle and thread, which is very simple as well. Push it through the folds from any one side to the other. Here I push from right side to left and again from left to right. Repeat the same for 3 to 4 times. And secure it with knots as shown here by slightly inserting the needle into the fabric and again passing it through the loop created by it. Make 2 such knots and cut it using scissors. I even filled up in between the creases. Apply hot glue and place the lace part by part. Once cut, go to the next one. One after the other, total I created 3 such lines. In the same way, complete all the 4 leaves. Now fix red small pom-poms at the top of these leaves using hot glue. Once you are done with all the 4 leaves, now apply hot glue at the tip of these typical leaves to create a loop to pass the thread through for the toran. And here also, fix the red small pom-poms using hot glue. Once you are done with all, arrange the toran in the pattern you wish them to be. Once confirmed, take a long thread to cover all the things in one. And using a needle, instead of passing the thread through the loops we created, we'll join all the pom-poms together. Better take a stronger thread than this seam thread. So later, after completing the toran, I replaced it with a stronger cotton twine. Make sure you leave some thread at the side before starting to join them, which later will be used to hang the toran. Carefully this way, join all the pom-poms together. Once you reach the end, leave some more thread, which later will be used to hang the toran. To work on the hanging part, I use the straws to join the hanging pom-poms. As you can notice, the hanging ones are in the decreasing order from top, big, middle and the small. Cut the straws in the same order, upper one bigger than the lower, so total you will have 5 big of 2 inches and 5 small ones of 1.5 inches. I got all these from just 4 straws, 2 yellow and 2 green. Using a needle and thread, push into the small one, then pass through the small straw. Continuing through the medium pom-pom and big straw. And finally, through the big one of the main strand. Secure with a knot as shown before. Repeat the same for rest 4 hanging sets. And for the lighting effect, you can carefully wrap the toran using string lights, which is optional. Once you have covered the entire length of toran and you're all set to go. I'm putting up a lot of hard work for these videos. Would appreciate your love. Hope you like my video. If yes, do like, share and subscribe if you haven't already. This would mean a lot to me to motivate me to come up with more such amazing budget-friendly decor ideas. You can follow me on my social media. Links will be in the description box below. Don't forget to check out how I made this URULI and DIYA decor. See you soon in my next video. Till then, take care. Love you all.